In part one of this video, we saw the top three UFO sightings from around the world. If you haven't watched it yet, don't worry. The link to the video is in the description below. From here on, we will explore UFO sightings in Earth's upper atmosphere. How NASA's New Horizons spacecraft was momentarily hacked in the Kuiper Belt, and how a strange piece of rock defied our understanding of physics. Welcome to Lab 360, it's time to explore. Have you ever experienced something surreal, something out of this world, for a brief second, and then, poof, gone? Did you try to tell your friends and family about it, but they laughed it off? Well, don't worry, because that makes you a part of the thousands of other people who have experienced the same. In fact, when the United States Unidentified Aerial Phenomena Task Force tried to identify 144 of these unidentified objects, they were able to pin down only one UAP. One, that's it? The remaining 143? They couldn't possibly describe what these objects were, because their aerodynamics was nothing like a man-made carrier. Cut to 2022, and NASA has decided to join the party, officially. Yes, the mega alien hunt is now on. The US Space Agency is launching a project that will recruit top scientists to examine unidentified aerial phenomena, or UAPs. This makes you wonder, is the USA hiding secrets about aliens? Or, are the extraterrestrials too intelligent to come under our radar? Carl Sagan had once said, "The universe is a pretty big place. If it's just us, seems like an awful waste of space." So, without further ado, let's start with the Kuiper Belt, which is a cold, dark, and distant space in the outer solar system. It's primarily made up of icy objects, dwarf planets, dust, and comets. So far, over 2,000 Kuiper Belt objects have been cataloged. Researchers believe these are only a tiny fraction of the total number of objects scientists think are out there. But one thing that fascinated NASA in the Kuiper Belt is the 15,810 Aran. A quick Google search will tell you that Aran is a Kuiper Belt object, a large rock that orbits round outside the orbit of Neptune. But, is it a rock? In April 2016, NASA's New Horizons spacecraft reached the Kuiper Belt. After capturing its first target, Pluto, the probe turned its sight towards a large object on a strange trajectory. Yes, we are talking about 15,810 Aran, named after the Celtic god of death, war, and the other world. Now, why is it so special, you ask? Well, most of the objects in the Kuiper Belt are made of rock and ice, but Aran doesn't move like any of cataloged object in the belt. This has made scientists question if it is made of something completely different, something much stronger, because it's rotating so fast that centrifugal force should have torn it apart. How could something spin so fast and stay intact? Scientists believe that the fast spin is creating artificial gravity, and gravity would be the most vital thing needed for long interstellar travel. You cannot have astronauts floating around the spacecraft while traversing hundreds of light years. This probed the New Horizon to take a closer look at the object. And here is when things turn strange. As the probe tried to get a closer look, suddenly, all of its sensors went dead, transmissions cut off. It was as if someone was monitoring our presence, someone or something that did not want us to know about them. But just before losing contact, NASA observed that Aran was spinning like a large spaceship would. Now, you can say that it might have been a technical glitch, but here is when things get crazier. Only when New Horizon moved away from Aran, it suddenly came back to life as if nothing had ever happened in the first place. Now I would leave it to you to assume what it was, but if it's an intelligent alien civilization, it makes complete sense to stay far away from Earth and silently observe us from the cold and dark space in the Kuiper Belt. What do you guys have to say? Moving on, the next on the list is an intergalactic traveler. Enter Oumuamua. On October the 19th, 2017, a strange cosmic object was discovered to be on its way out of the solar system when astronomers spotted it with the Pan-STARRS radio telescope in Hawaii. The strange object was nomenclated Oumuamua, the first known interstellar object to visit the solar system, and it was, from the moment of its discovery, a weird object, weird orbit, weird speed, weird properties. Two things that made Oumuamua stand out was: A, it suddenly got a boost and left the solar system faster than it had entered, and B, its weird cigar-like shape. Tumbling through space at 90,000 kilometers per hour, the object is thought to have come from the direction of Vega, an alien star that resides 237 trillion kilometers away. And by the time it was spotted, it had already zipped by our own sun, performed a slick hairpin turn, and begun hurtling off in another direction. Scientists scratched their heads and kept switching between an asteroid and a comet to fit what Oumuamua is. We finally settled for a comet at last, because that was the only possible explanation we could come up with for its sudden speed up, although we never spotted its tail, a characteristic that sets comets aside from asteroids. Harvard astronomer Avi Loeb, however, feels that it is an artificial construction made by an intelligent extraterrestrial civilization, because it challenged our physics and baffled everyone. It may be an active reconnaissance craft, sent here to check out our solar system, the researcher wrote in his study. If I created an interstellar spacecraft, whose identity I would like to hide, I would make sure it looked like a piece of rock, only slightly unusual, just to tease any slow-witted alien civilizations. And Oumuamua did just that. It left the solar system at an incredible speed, never to be seen again. Astronomers have used the Green Bank Telescope in West Virginia and the Allen Telescope Array in Northern California to listen for any possible pings coming from Oumuamua. To date, the object has remained silent. Next up is an array of UFOs. Seeing one UFO is exciting, perhaps intoxicating even. But what would you say to an array of UFOs parked in a line? Astronaut Gordon Cooper, who flew both the Mercury 9 and the Gemini 5, claims to have seen an entire convoy of UFOs during his time with the Air Force. Interestingly, 10 years later, he came across something very similar. In 1963, while on a solo journey around the Earth, when he was just finishing his 22-orbit trip, he saw a green glowing object hurtling towards his Mercury capsule. The scene was picked up on radar by the tracking station in Mushe, Australia, which makes it quite extraordinary and very believable. When he described the incident to the United Nations, he said that these extraterrestrial vehicles and their crews were visiting from other planets. He said that while most astronauts are reluctant to discuss UFOs, in 1951 he had the privilege of seeing several UFOs of different sizes, flying in fighter formation, in the general direction of east to west, over Europe. Well, like many experts say, the proof is out there. And I, for one, am pretty sure that we are not alone, and we are under constant supervision. What do you guys have to say? Drop in your comments below, and don't forget to subscribe to Lab 360, together we explore.